Here at home, after some relief, local pump prices are seen rising again next week. Jackie Manaba tells us more.
For the first time since the start of the year, oil prices went down. Effective Tuesday, gasoline prices will decrease by 5 pesos and 45 centavos per liter, diesel by 11 pesos and 45 centavos per liter, and kerosene by 8 pesos and 55 centavos per liter. The Energy Department said this could be attributed to the re-emergence of COVID in China and the possible meeting between the leaders of Russia and Ukraine.
Dalawa po ang nakita nating mga report na dominantly nagpo-point dun sa agarang pag-rollback. Number one, yung Ukrainian president nag-declare na hindi na siya interesado dun sa NATO membership. At yan ay responded kaagad ng Russia, which pointed out na isa yan sa core conditions nila, which highlighted na mukhang interesado yung Russia upuan yung peace talk.
Some motorists filled up their gas tanks as soon as they heard the good news.
Sa tingin ko, malamang baka tumaas eh, di ba? Pakarga ka na para siguradong meron, di ba? Habang mababa ang presyo.
However, public utility jeepney drivers are still not happy with the rollback. They could still not afford the current rates while the minimum fare is stuck at 9 pesos for years.
Wala, sus Maria, ang hirap. Minsan nauwi ako 400, napunta sa Kurudo lahat. Mataas pa po yan.
Since the start of the year, there is a total net increase of 15 to 20 pesos per liter in the price of petroleum products. And the bad news is, oil prices could go up next week.
Pataas na actually ngayon, isang trading day pa lang this week. So kaya ko nasasabi na may indication na posibleng magkaroon ng increase next week. Of course, subject to the actual pa na apat na trading days na darating at sana bumaba yung price.
The prices of oil price increases is brought about by Russia's invasion of Ukraine. Russia is among the world's biggest oil producers. Even if Russia is not a supplier of oil and gas to the Philippines, which is heavily dependent on imported oil, the global supply disruptions caused oil prices to spike. The DOE assures the public that the country's oil supply is sufficient amid the Russia-Ukraine conflict. Jackie Manabat, ABS-CBN News.
U.S. President Joe Biden expected to announce a joint action aimed at enhancing European energy security and reducing its dependence on Russian oil and natural gas. Biden is traveling to Europe this week, his first visit since Russia invaded Ukraine. He will meet with NATO allies, G7 leaders, and European Union leaders.
He will have the opportunity to coordinate on the next phase of military assistance to Ukraine. He will join our partners in imposing further sanctions on Russia and tightening the existing sanctions to crack down on evasion and to ensure robust enforcement. He will work with allies on longer-term adjustments to NATO force posture on the eastern flank. He will announce joint action on enhancing European energy security and reducing Europe's dependence on Russian gas at long last.
EU foreign ministers are split on whether the bloc should join the U.S. in banning Russian oil. Some countries, including Germany, say the bloc is too dependent on Russia's fossil fuels to withstand such a step. Brent crude declining 14 cents to $115 a barrel on Tuesday, while the U.S. West Texas Intermediate crude settled at nearly $112 a barrel as traders weigh the prospects of an EU ban on Russian crude.